Saturday night. It's the eve of SummerSlam, and the highway to hell is headed for Madison Square Garden.
And last Monday was hell for the tag team champions Kane and Mankind. They battled each other in a Hell in a Cell.
And will Dustin Runnels turn the other cheek when he goes one-on-one tonight with the European champion D'Lo Brown? That and much more right here tonight on Shotgun, Saturday night. Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Shotgun Saturday Night. I'm Jim Ross alongside James E. Cornette. We are stationed at ringside on the eve of SummerSlam.
The following non-title contest is scheduled for one ball for the 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, representing the nation, formerly in Chicago, Illinois, now from Lisbon, Portugal.
He just bought a home there, JR, in Portugal.
What?
The World Wrestling Federation, the European champion.
They treat him like a king there.
His opponent from Austin, Texas, weighing 262 pounds, Dustin Runnels.
Chance for Dustin to score an upset before SummerSlam.
Indeed, ladies and gentlemen, we are pumped up because we are less than 24 hours away. Tomorrow night on pay-per-view, it is SummerSlam.
That's right. This is the last bump in the road on the highway to hell. And for the two men traveling that path, crying won't help them and praying won't do them no good. They're going to hell at SummerSlam.
Boy, you're fired up tonight, aren't you?
Hey, that word's in the Bible. I can say it on television.
This is a non-title matchup. Of course, D'Lo Brown will defend the European title tomorrow night on pay-per-view at SummerSlam against Val Venus from the sold-out Madison Square Garden. And the capacity crowd here, James E., expressing their feelings toward our renowned and much-beloved European champion.
That's right, another question that D'Lo Brown has been asking, he's asked everybody, Madison Square Garden is not located in Europe. Whoa, spitting Dustin's face right there. Why should he have to defend the European title at Madison Square Garden?
In front of the atomic drop. Because he signed the contract would be a good reason for me, but in any event, take it up with Mr. McMahon.
Well, I think there was some shady dealings going on there. Big backdrop, and D'Lo Brown goes down.
Well, the dealing has gone down with The Undertaker and Kane for SummerSlam. And the deal is this. The two brothers are together, and that spells trouble for Stone Cold Steve Austin.
With a capital T, because we talked about it last week. If indeed, wait a minute, D'Lo has taken the European title belt, and it looks like he's heading back to Lisbon. We talked about it last week. If Kane and The Undertaker were really together, then there's no power on earth, no force that could stop them. And we found out that's exactly what the case is. They are together.
I find it nearly impossible for Stone Cold to overcome those odds, those two giant seven-footers, together with one thing on their mind, and that is for The Undertaker to leave Madison Square Garden after this SummerSlam pay-per-view extravaganza with the WWF title in the family's possession. And boy, wouldn't that make Mr. McMahon happy.
I'll tell you, I think it would, although it might be going out of the frying pan and into the fire with what The Undertaker did to Mr. McMahon this past Monday, but you got to realize they've got to be sneaky about this because it's still a one-on-one match, Stone Cold against The Undertaker. If Kane's going to interfere, he's going to have to be sneaky about it. He's going to have to do it behind the referee's back. And I know that on
the cover and an air fall by the European champion in this non-title match.
On Sunday Night Heat tomorrow night, Stone Cold is bound to await the arrival of The Undertaker and Kane at Madison Square Garden with some kind of equalizer. We're going to be there. We're going to be there live on USA. So, wait a minute.
Another cover from the leg drop and another near fall.
It just remains to be seen what kind of plan that Austin has to get rid of one or both before SummerSlam starts.
Well, as you said, Sunday Night Heat on the USA Network, 7, 6 Central. Tomorrow night it's live. Ooh. And D'Lo Brown now widening the offensive advantage here. And certainly that leads us to remind everyone that SummerSlam on pay-per-view starts at 8 o'clock on Sunday night. An hour later than normal, 8 o'clock starting time. And Dustin Runnels is showing up a competitive spirit, James. But that chest protector can... Well, I think it's more than just a chest protection, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, Dustin, whoa, there he caught him. He was trying to shoot those gut shots in underneath the chest protector and not getting them all underneath it, but he got that one right on the button, and that one, too, he's going high.
And speaking of chest protectors, we're going to find out who Sable's tag team partner's going to be tomorrow night on Heat.
Now, you got to do stuff like that. First match.
Oh, wait a minute. His knee may have just gone out on him.
He came down sideways on that leapfrog. And D'Lo Brown's 300 pounds, even though he doesn't move like it. When that much weight comes down on a man's leg and he comes down wrong or with the leg locked, it could be a torn anterior cruciate ligament, maybe a medial collateral.
Or it could be trying to dupus.
What kind of a dupus ligament? I've never heard of a dupus ligament.
Well, you don't even look like Dr. Jim Andrews.
What's wrong with this knee?
Dustin Runnels asking the question, too. D'Lo Brown seems like he's in a lot of pain.
Well, this match has come to a sudden halt here. And if D'Lo Brown is indeed injured, his chances of perhaps even competing at SummerSlam would be dampened here. Remember, D'Lo has a European title match scheduled with Val Venus on pay-per-view, and Dustin trying to extend a helping hand here.
A hand of friendship. Dustin Runnels indeed turns the other cheek again. I think the referee's going to...
Wait, look out! Oh! Well, D'Lo couldn't be trusted. Just as we suspected, there's a sky high and be followed by the low down. Oh! D'Lo Brown just up... Duped the group of us here.
Hey, I wasn't fooled. I knew it all the time he was playing possum. I was just trying to help him in his charade. And I'll tell you this, Val Venus is going to have to watch out for the sky high, the low down, the chest protector, and D'Lo Brown if he's going to get that European title.
Turning point of the match right here, D'Lo Brown. A knee injury that hit his high impact move there. Followed it with another. That was just too much for Dustin Runnels.
And Dustin Runnels shakes hands with referee Earl Hebner. Boy, he'll turn the other cheek until he's got no cheeks left, JR.
He's damn near cheekless as it is.
Just about.
Folks, there's still a time tonight here on SummerSlam Eve. Just hours away from pay-per-view in Madison Square Garden. We'll update you, rattlesnakes and all.
Plus, carnage fills the air when Kane and Mankind enter the Hell in a Cell. You're not going to believe this action.